Hey everyone, I'm Joe with Rogue Fabrication. We just came out with a new attachment for the M600 tubing bender. This is a mandrel attachment. For those of you who don't know what a mandrel tubing bender is, when you're bending thin-walled tubing, if you want to bend something really thin-wall, you will get terrible wrinkles beyond a certain point in terms of wall thickness, ratios, that kind of thing. So, what a mandrel bender does is it puts a bullet or multi-ball plug inside of the tubing while it's being bent. And then the tubing gets drawn over that, and this gets held in place by the rod in this huge attachment. So the tubing slides on over that rod and allows you to put your bends as far from the end of the tubing as your frame is long. And it makes your bends have much nicer bend quality too. This one is deformed about 3.5% or so. So it's a pretty darn nice looking bend. And it's very thin. This is 1¼" 049 wall, 1020 DOM. And like you saw in that other piece, normally on any rotary draw bender, if you put that in it on any reasonably tight radius, it's just going to wrinkle up immediately. So that's the whole point of this, is doing tighter radii in bending or thinner wall relative to the diameter in bending. Those things all save weight, save space, and allow you to do more high performance work, exhaust work, turbo manifolds, all that kind of cool stuff. So let me tell you a little more about this attachment. I'm going to go behind the machine here. Like I said, this is the rod that the tubing slides over. You load the machine from the front all the way over to this point. It's stopped before it hits the adapter back here, and that dictates your maximum spacing on your bends, which this machine is long enough to bend roughly 5.5 feet from the end of the tubing, and of course, infinitely long out the front. So you could take a 20-foot stick, slide this on, and use it to build any roll cage component, nearly any reasonable chassis component. There will be extensions available for this frame and the rod to make it even longer, but you'll probably also notice there's a grease pump on this. Why is it there? This is the pump for the through mandrel lubrication on this machine. To further improve bending performance and reduce friction and extend mandrel life, these mandrels have little tiny holes in them and a little groove. And so this pumps a high performance mandrel bending lubrication, Bendall 002, which we've been selling for about 18 months, through these lines, into the adapter, through the hollow rod, all the way into the end where the mandrels are, and it squeezes out as the material is being bent, if you choose to pump this while the material is being bent. It doesn't take a whole lot, so you'll have to pump that once every maybe 10 degrees or so, if you want to. If not, you just rub the lubrication on and be done with it. It still does work. As the material is bent, it squeezes down on the mandrel. The mandrel's holding it open. That, of course, creates a whole lot of friction, like the lubrication's here. And it makes the mandrel stay in the tubing after you bend it, unless you have a way to extract it. So this machine has a 1-inch Acme screw in the back here, and you just turn this crank and it pulls the mandrel right out. It is extremely easy to do. So our mandrel is set for 4.5-inch CLR. We're going to go up one slot in here, up to the 3.5-inch CLR setting. So we pull off the clip, put the plates open, and you flip the back plate over. Back in here for the pins. There's one side, and there's the other side. And then that clip goes back on, and now it's secured and ready to be used on 3.5-inch centerline radius. So those are all for different levels within the machine where that mandrel has to go to match up with the die you're bending on. We'll have a full instructional video that'll explain all the operational details, but that's basically the short of how this attachment works and why we made it. Now, I'm going to come up close to the camera again and show you some more of the tubing we've bent. Some of this stuff is kind of more exciting than others. So, all the stuff we've bent has had between 1.5% and 5% deformation. So, the bends look nice and round on the outside, and of course, true to all of our nominal shape bending dies, the bends on the inside are nearly perfect. There is a little bump in the very beginning when the bend starts. To get rid of that, a mandrel bender would have to have a wiper die, which goes between the bending die and the mandrel. It's a little piece of slice shaped thing. Mandrel benders that have wiper dies start like more expensive than a house. They're kind of beyond the scope of this, but that's the only way to get rid of that little bump there, which is pretty minor. This is 3AL 2.5V titanium alloy. That's a titanium that I believe is alloyed with vanadium and aluminum to make it even stronger than commercially pure titanium. This happens to be cold work stress relieved, so it's abbreviated CWSR. That stuff is a little bit easier to form than just cold worked titanium alloy. And so this is the most commonly used commercially available titanium alloy. It's high strength, easy to weld, and has fantastic other properties as well. So this is the one everybody would want to bend more than commercially pure. It's the one we've been bending and it works. This is 1.5 inch, 070. So this would be great for making frames for, I don't know, a sand rail or a really heavy quad or dirt bike or motorcycle or something, but also for exhaust work. Titanium is fantastic for heat resistance and tolerance, just like Inconel, and it's also very, very light. Unlike aluminum, this is way, way, way more rigid per pound than steel. Aluminum and steel have roughly the same rigidity per pound, similar to magnesium also. But this is the actual, the big deal, the free lunch in material science. You get way more strength per pound and rigidity per pound out of titanium. This is 1.625, 083 chromoly. It's 4130 alloy. It's normalized. That is exactly the same stuff that is in nearly every single SFI rulebook that the NHRA references for safety for drag racing chassis building. And this one is deformed about 3%, so round on the inside, on the sides, around the inside as well. It looks wonderful. And this is on a 4.5 inch radius. Previous to the mandrel attachment, you would have to bend this on a 6 inch radius in our machine, or at least a 5.5 in all of our competitors. And with all of those machines, either two places here or on the outside, you're going to get significant deformation. The racing industry has been tolerating this for years because previous to this, mandrel benders started for this diameter at about $15,000 without tooling. This one, you'll see on our webpage, is tremendously more affordable than that. It's really, really affordable. So you can go to our webpage, roguefab.com, click on products, tubing benders. You'll find the mandrel attachment in there, both with and without the through mandrel lubrication injection system. And you'll find all the mandrels we currently have available. As of the recording of this video, that is only about 6 mandrels, but we're making them based on requests. So if you have a need for a specific size and you're prepared to purchase one or investigate what that would involve, feel free to email us. Let us know what size in terms of diameter of the material, wall thickness of the material, and the centerline radius you want to bend on. When you do that, as you'll read in our mandrel attachment description, we're going to also let you know that wall ratios beyond 30, like above 30, are not likely to be feasible, and D ratios below 2.5 are also not likely to be feasible. If you don't know what those mean, our webpage will teach you. Our tech section has that information and a whole lot more. So feel free to comment on this video, like it. We have shockingly few subscribers on YouTube. We want more, so that could be you. Please subscribe, and then don't be a stranger. Let us know what you think.